hit the ball higher and straighter from the fairway, the sand, and the rough. Order the hybrid approach wedge, risk-free for only $99. Visit us at hwedge.com.
Two big mistakes I see with amateurs in putting is that they don't set up to the ball correctly and they rotate the club face too much in the stroke, which makes it very inconsistent. So the thing that we have to make sure for setting up is that we get our eyes over or slightly inside of the golf ball, and we have to make sure that when we set up, we're bent over enough that when we let the right hand fall away from the putter, you'll see that it falls straight down the line. That's gonna allow me to make a stroke that works straight back and straight through. If I have a putter that's too long, or I stand up too much, or I use my shoulders too much around my body, I'm gonna have a tendency to drop that hand away, and you'll see that it falls to the inside. And when that happens, I'm gonna tend to pull the putter away inside or cause problems with my path. So we need to get over the ball more, a little bit more bent over. Typically means you need actually a shorter putter, usually around 33 or 34 inches is correct. And then we have to make sure that we keep the face square. A putter like this, if you'll see, if you balance it on your finger, the face of the putter faces straight up in the air. That means it's called a face balanced putter. And that type of putter is designed to swing back straight without the club face rotating very much. If I balance it and the face of the putter drops down, that putter is designed to rotate a little more. Ben Crenshaw was a great putter, one of the best ever, and he had a lot of face rotation in his putting stroke, but he practiced every single day and hit thousands and thousands of putts. So a putter that's face balanced is gonna allow you to have a stroke where the face doesn't rotate near as much in the backswing. We don't want this rotation open and shut because that's gonna create a lot of variability in the putting stroke. One of the best ways to do that is to make sure that your right shoulder moves up and your left shoulder moves up. We don't want the body rotating around the spine. We don't want head movement, and we certainly don't want any rolling or unrolling of the wrists. If we get set up correctly, and we simply allow the right shoulder to move up and the left shoulder to move up, the face will stay quite square and you'll make a lot of putts.